Hi guys, my name is Laurent. Happy Valentine's Day. Today, I'm gonna show you a... Let me drink first. I'm gonna show you a quick and easy way to make a nice dinner. Here is the simple tool you need at home. It's a bowl to whip the cream, a peeler, a whisk, a knife, and a cutting board. For the menu, it's gonna be beef carpaccio with balsamic and ginger syrup, baby arugula and parmesan cheese. For the entree, it's gonna be a scallop with a sweet potato mash with basil leaves and basil oil. And the dessert is gonna be a berry's heart with whipped cream and caramel sauce. I'm gonna present you the ingredients that you can all find in a local grocery store. The black sea salt that you can switch with regular sea salt, extra virgin olive oil, balsamic vinegar, salt, pepper, ginger powder. Right here is the piment d'espelette from France, but you can switch with paprika. Here is the protein, which is the beef fillet and the scallops. The dairy, heavy cream, parmesan cheese, puff pastry, butter and eggs. And the fruit and vegetable, berries, basil, baby arugula, tomato, sweet potato. We're all set, let's get started. Okay guys, so now we're gonna do the beef fillet. So we're just gonna roll it in a plastic wrap just to give him a nice shape. It's very easy. And then we're gonna put it in the freezer for 15-30 minutes. You see it's like a bonbon. 15-30 minutes to make it easier for you guys to cut it later. So now we're gonna do the balsamic and ginger syrup. Pour a quarter cup of balsamic vinegar. Then a little bit of ground ginger and 3 tablespoons of sugar. You're just gonna mix it a little bit and you're gonna cook it down for about 5 to 10 minutes until it reduces by half and get like a syrup texture. And we're gonna use this as a sauce for the carpaccio. Now we're gonna plate the carpaccio. For this we need tomato. We're gonna make some nice slice. You can use a red tomato as well, but I think the yellow one looks much nicer. Now we're gonna slice the beef. So try to make it as thin as you can, but not too thin. You don't want to break the slice. And if it's a little bit too thick, I'm gonna show you an example. You can just use the back of the knife to make it thinner. So now that you got the meat, we're gonna season it a little bit with the nice black sea salt we got. If not, you can use any kind of sea salt. Balsamic syrup. Okay. Olive oil. Parmesan, right on the salad. Nice shred. Here we go. Ready to eat. So now we're gonna prepare the sweet potato for the mash, sweet potato. So we're just gonna wrap it in aluminum foil, stick in the oven for 30 minutes. Alright, so now we're gonna do the fried basil leaves, fried sweet potato, basil oil, extra virgin olive oil. Not too much. While it's getting hot, we're gonna chop one bunch of the basil leaves, just roll it and chop it. Alright, now we're gonna peel the sweet potato. So, alright, that's enough. Now that the oil is hot enough, we're gonna start frying the basil leaves. So be careful, because when you throw it in the oil, it can splash a little bit. So just wait 15-20 seconds until it gets translucent. Just make sure you use a long tongue, because it's pretty hot. That's gonna be to decorate the roasted scallop dish. Now we're gonna do the same with the sweet potato. Try to pull it nice so it stays as long as you can. It's gonna be a little faster, just 20 seconds. Remove it before it starts getting too much color. And to finish the chopped basil, be careful. Just 15 seconds is enough. Just pour it in a bowl and keep it on the side for later. So now we're gonna saute the scallops. So we need a hot pan. So we're gonna use canola oil or vegetable oil. While it's getting hot, we're gonna season the scallop. not too much. There's already salt from the sea. Pepper. Then when they all start getting smoky, you can saute the scallops 1 minute on each side. And right now you should have the sweet potato ready, so you can start plating while you're cooking the scallops. So now that the oil is really hot, we're gonna saute it 1 minute each side. 1 minute, we're just gonna wait to get a nice color. You can just add a piece of butter now for the flavor to get a nice color. So 1 minute on each side is enough. You don't want it overcooked, it's gonna get chewy or that. Okay, so now we get the sweet potato ready to get mashed. So we're just gonna unwrap it. Be careful, it's hot, came out from the oven. Just cut in half, just squeeze it into the bowl. Okay, we're gonna add butter. Don't be cheap with the butter, that's where the flavor is. Salt. We're just gonna match it. See, very simple. So this is gonna stay hot for 2-3 minutes, so we can do the scallops right now. Now the basil oil, basilic dry leaves. And just to finish, espelette pepper. You can switch with paprika or any spices you like. Now we're gonna do the puff pastry heart. We got the puff pastry right here, parchment paper, the oven at 350, 1x. Take a piece of paper, fold in two by the size of the puff pastry. Draw a nice heart. Here we go. So there is one. You have no brush, that's fine. Nobody gonna see, you can use your finger. Now we're gonna do the caramel sauce for the berries heart. Sugar. Gonna add some water to make a caramel. The water is just to make the cooking more even, so it's gonna be easier to make the caramel. Can put full fire. And we're gonna wait until it gets caramelized. Alright, so now you can see it start getting color. In about 30 seconds, it's gonna get really dark. Alright, turn off the fire. And watch out. So now we're gonna do the berries heart. So we got the nice puff pastry. So we're just gonna make a small pattern again to make a small heart. Very easy. All right. Then we're gonna put the powdered sugar like this. It's gonna be nice. So now we're gonna whip the cream to make the caramel whipped cream. Just need to whisk, make like an 8. This is gonna take about 5 minutes. Before it gets thick, we're gonna add some powdered sugar. We're almost there. As you can see, it's getting pretty hard. Now we add the caramel sauce. It's gonna give a good taste of the chantilly. All right, ready? Now we're gonna slice the biscuits in 3 layers. Using a bread knife or whatever you have. One, this is 2. So we're gonna keep the top right here. Okay. All right. Then we put the second layer, all right. A little bit of whipped cream again. And then we're gonna add the strawberry that we're gonna slice first. Okay. And just to finish, we're gonna put the powdered sugar. And that's it. Okay, so here we got the 3 dishes ready. The beef carpaccio, the roasted scallops, the berries heart. I see you next time.